Hi everyone, welcome to my view, David Lean's Brief Encounter from 1945. So yes, finally back here to talk about another David Lean film, and here it is on Blu-ray. Rewatched this a few weeks ago actually, not really had the time to review this, and I thought, you know, it's a film that I can review it, you know, a few weeks on from, you know, giving it a watch again, because it always sticks in my mind, this film, and, you know, yes, I just didn't have the time, I didn't want to rush, you know, various reviews. I've got quite a few backlogged, but here we are finally to talk about this film. Not going to be a massive review. You know, this is a film actually, you know, it's kind of nice to do maybe a little bit of a shorter review actually, and it's just a film that, you know, if you haven't seen the film, of course, first of all, you know, spoilers alert. We'll be getting into some of the plot details, including of course the ending. So please, you know, I just urge you to go and watch this film if you have the time. Very short film, of course, and also, if you, you know, if it's available to you, you know, for example, Blu-ray, etc. But yes, this film, of course, very, very famous piece of work here. You know, I'd heard about this for many, many years, you know, many, many years, wanting to see this, eventually getting the Blu-ray and watching this for the first time, 2017, yeah, 2 years ago. Here we are, with the first rewatch here, you know, along with some other David Lean films, and that was back, you know, last year, you know, I watched a few Leans, just like this year, in succession, you could say, or around the same sort of time, you know, scale. And here we are again, actually this time trying to watch all of the David Lean films, you know, within the space of a few months. And, you know, even including, of course, his later films that I've never seen, Dr. Zhivago, etc. But yes, this film, of course, really is one of his very, very most loved films. And you really could say it's just Lawrence of Arabia, actually, and maybe Bridge on the River Kwai, the kind of, you know, battle it out for the top spot, really. These three films, I feel, it seems, you know, these are the most popular. There's quite a few people who would say this is the finest David Lean picture, and one of his earliest films, of course, or one of his early stage films, before he made, you know, all these big, big epics. And this is, you know, compared to Lawrence of Arabia, it is a very, very small film, very, very modest, of course, completely different. You know, it just shows the genius, you know, one of the genius things about David Lean is just this transition and all the variety of films he made. But this film is a very, very personal, very, very short film, very, you know, kind of just, yes, a very short romance, and a very different romance. This is kind of part of the realist, you know, movement, really, and it's part of this, you know, kind of vein of cinema, the realist cinema, and it's very, very different for a romance, of course, in the way it ends, and just the way that these two fall in love, you know, it is, of course, very, very different to a lot of romances, but of course, if you know me, you know, my channel, I do love, you know, romances, especially classic romances, whether that be Hollywood or, you know, whatever, just classic romance films. I just, you know, I much prefer these types of films, and I think, you know, some of the very, very best films are, you know, in this category for me. I just love so many you know, classic romances, just this feeling, you know, so many pure romances are, you know, just done in this way. I just respond to this kind of style you know, a lot more, and just so happens so many of you know, these films from this kind of vein cinema are just, you know, among my very, very favourites. I think I'm kind of in the kind of you know, kind of that train of thought that when a romance is done, you know, like one of the best romances kind of thing, I think it's very, very hard to top. You know, it really, really is. Just example, City Lights, you know, that's in my top 10 of all time, of course. And yes, this film, you know, in that sense, I was very, very hyped. Of course, I had seen The Third Man, you know, Trevor Howard, of course, being in that. And I think just knowing that as well, that he'd be, you know, one of the main stars, just, I was so hyped for this film. And, you know, hearing as well, it's one of the best, apparently one of the best British films, you know, BFI and stuff, you know, kind of count this as one of the very, very finest romances. And yes, we must say that I was, you know, this actually, despite all this prestigious, you know, kind of acclaim, it did, in so many regards, exceed my expectations. I must say that. I think this is one of the very, very finest films in general that I've had the pleasure of viewing. Very, very brief, you know, very, very brief, of course, but so, so meaningful, so, so pure. This is how you do a romance. It's also not a film that is kind of forced at all. It's not also a film where there's as much emotion that you'd maybe expect from a romance film, in the terms of, you know, just the way the characters express this. It's very, very introvert, in its kind of, in it, you know, its characters. It's a lot more subtle than a lot of romances I've ever seen. But, you know, it is there, and I felt, you know, so much from watching this. I think there is, of course, moments of, you know, pure joy and stuff. But these characters, you know, they kind of act in the ways they think they should, and that kind of alters, you know, the way that we see this romance unfold. But of course, Celia Johnson, wow, so wonderful in this film. And of course, Trevor Howard, you know, doesn't get too much more kind of charming, you know, than, you know, him as an actor. I think he's just so, so, so good. Of course, in The Third Man as well, just a real presence. This is his best performance I've seen. And yes, what a character. One of my favourite characters in a film, really. Just so, so comforting, you know, to see him kind of, the relationship, you know, kind of unravel across the film, with him, of course, playing Alec, the doctor, and of course, falling in love with Laura. And of course, she is married, and so is he. This is the story, of course, as we know, they meet at the, you see the train station scene at the beginning, and then of course, it kind of tells, you know, what has happened up to this point for most of the rest of the film. And then of course, right near the end, we see basically the final scene again there at the train station, very, very close to the final scene anyway. And then of course, it unfolds a bit differently, you see different things, and of course you've got this whole, you know, perspective, you know, behind that scene for it to actually fully play out. And that is the film in a nutshell. That's, you know, structure. You see all these different scenes, of course, how they, you know, met, these two characters, how they fell in love, and of course, the way in which they respond, you know, to this, and how, of course, them being, you know, having families, husband and wives, of course, very, very complex. But as we know, this is not a film that kind of ends in a way that you would maybe expect, or certainly, I think, want to kind of happen, just in terms of, you know, romance, you know, piece of cinema here. You'd want, of course, well, I do anyway, I wanted the characters to kind of end up together. Unfortunately, famously, that does not happen. You know, we'll get to that. But yes, in that sense, a very, very different romance, you know, in that way. But also, there's something about this, it's just so pure. It's also, it's got all these kind of, you know, these things that I love about classic romances, but it's very, very different. It's got a kind of a darker feeling, a much more kind of restrained feeling at times. And I think just the way the narration, the character of Laura, very, very, very different to a lot of romances that I've seen. Of course, the film is basically told through, you know, she narrates as if she's kind of, you know, revealing this to her husband, a confession, if you will. That's kind of sounds right. You know, yes, this kind of confession to her husband, you know, as if she is telling him what has happened. And, you know, she doesn't in the end, of course. But yeah, this is how the film is kind of told to us. She's kind of recounting these encounters, very, very brief, fleeting moments. You know, it's not a kind of epic romance, you know, big, big scale, or, you know, across a massive time period at all. It's a film that, you know, is told kind of through these flashbacks, if you will, and it just, you know, these characters interacting a lot of the time, not really in the sense of traditional dialogue scenes. You've got her narrating, of course, Celia Johnson, in a very, very, you know, kind of untypical way, actually. And, you know, it's very, very honest in that sense. A very, you know, yeah, to the point, very, very kind of just, you know, true to what she's, what she feels. It's not, it doesn't feel staged at all either. It's just wonderful narration. Of course, she is talking over many, many scenes. We don't actually really hear as much. A lot of the time, the characters actually talking to each other. It's more visually told in that sense. But at the same time, she's narrating, giving her kind of perspective on things. the pain, the kind of the sadness comes from that combination. Seeing these at times, you know, purely joyous moments, these visual moments of, you know, this love unfolding, and then of course her, you know, narrating this, and we know of course the context a bit more as the film goes on, and then of course linking back, you know, in that final scene there, or one of the final scenes at the train station, to one of the really the most, one of the most shattering, you know, moments in cinema, where of course they part ways, and who knows if they ever got back together at all, or met again, even, but you know, we don't really know that, but of course it's just, you know, while the end, you know, the end is not exactly, you know, to me, you know, fully something that, you know, I would have preferred, of course, you know, for them to, of course, have kind of ended up together, you know, maybe like the third man, but of course, in the context of this film, it does make sense fully, and of course, you know, it is something that's very, very dark. Some people could find it depressing, and I think, you know, I think what I take from the film is the in-between, of course, the meeting, you know, of the two characters, and how, you know, it's just so natural and so investing. Straight away, we see, of course, she has grit in her eye, Laura, and basically Alec, you know, comes to her aid and basically helps her there, and they, of course, have another kind of chance encounter, but then after that, they do, you know, kind of agree to meet up, for example, going to the cinema. Yeah, what a wonderful film, really, really wonderful film here, and just going, you know, to locations, to the park, it's just a beautiful film, you know, and of course, the bridge scene, of course, well, two instances there, just one, you know, one kind of such scenes that just moved me to tears. You know, this is a film that's very, very simple at times in the way it's told, and that is one of its, you know, many, many strengths. You know, I think this is just, it's one of the greatest masterpieces, because of how pure it is in its storytelling, and of course the acting is just masterful, the cinematography, the editing, once again, of course, David Lean, his films are edited so well, you know, and of course we have Noel Coward working with him, working with Lean, of course, and a couple of others on the screenplay, based off of his very, very short play, Noel Coward, I think that was 36, and yes, of course, you know, the music by Rachmaninoff, you know, basically, yeah, Sergei Rachmaninoff, the music there, and it's used, the main piece of music, classical piece, of course, used throughout the film, and that is just wonderful. It just adds such a kind of emotion to the film. You know, really, this is a spiritual experience, I feel, you know, like the best films, and it just offers this pure romance. I'm so invested in these characters and the relationship they have, and then of course, what a shattering ending, of course, and she does go back to her husband. They both go back to their families, you know, as we see, and of course they feel that they can't be together, it's impossible, and of course that is the way the film ends, and you know, what a bold move by everyone involved there, and you know, at the same time, of course, yes, there is something about the film, it could have been even higher on my list, if the ending had, just to me, been a bit more satisfying. This is a perfect film in my opinion, but of course, just in comparison with some other films, this could have been even higher on my list, but it is in my top, you know, 75, I'll just say that now, so extremely, extremely high, but it could have been a little bit higher, if it had just kind of satisfied me bit more. You know, I am fully immersed in this film throughout, you know, and I think it's one of the most beautiful, moving films I've ever seen. Literally, after that first sort of 10 minutes or so, you know, once this film really opens up, you know, I think it's one of the most emotional films. You know, I'm constantly in tears, you know, it's just it's uplifting. And of course, these characters, you know, especially, of course, Alec, kind of just doing what they want, in this sense, you know, throughout all the film, and the way they kind of just go off and spend time together, and kind of this, it's just this feeling in the film, so sincere, but kind of, yeah, it's very hard to explain, spontaneous maybe it feels at times, just the way these characters are acting, and I think I just connect to these characters so much, you know, I really wanted for these characters to kind of end up together. Of course they don't, which is not, you know, as I say, it's not a flaw at all. It's something that just simply, of course, I would have preferred even more if it kind of ended with them, of course, ended up together. But of course, this is a very, very different romance. It is one of my favourites, absolutely, because of how much I connect to this relationship, the joy in seeing this unfold, and actually the individual characters, just how charming they are. Performances, of course, Celia Johnson, flawless, absolutely flawless, and same, of course, with Trevor Howard, you know, absolutely, in many regards, some of the best performances, really, both of them, you know, among them. I think it's just, you know, it's a film that there's not a single flaw for me personally, and I think it just really elevates, you know, in its visual storytelling, and it's just the emotion I get from this, the purity, and of course all these different moments, you know, fleeting moments, and the way that I kind of I experience them, and all this kind of the aspects of the film, that it is one of the absolute finest that I've ever witnessed. And I think, you know, is it my favourite Lean film? Find out, and of course, you know, it certainly is at least one of the finest films ever made, so it doesn't really matter if it's my favourite Lean film, but it is, as I say, in my top 75. I think it's just, you know, a real treat. It really is a gift, you know, from David Lean and everyone involved, of course, to us, to experience, and of course, just, you know, this kind of plays out like a kind of dream in many instances, dream sequences, you could say, and just how purely wonderful they are, how, of course, they're presented, the kind of fades at times, the way it's kind of very, very quick in its, you know, in the movement, the flow of it, and kind of just, yes, this fleeting feel that it has actually adds to the kind of the sadness as well. What a film, you know, the joy, the pure joy in seeing these characters be together, of course, you know, just watching, as a viewer, to watch this, you know, for example, the cinema scenes, the comedy in the film, you know, it's a hilarious film, the scene, of course, with the boat, you know, all these moments, you know, it's a purely, you know, humorous film, it's got a wonderful spirit, and, you know, it's also a very, very dark film in some places, towards the end, the way it ends, of course, very, very sad, no doubt there, but, you know, something that, within this, you've got so much just, you know, purely uplifting and, you know, just happy moments, I feel. And of course, these characters are just so good. I connected to them. So invested in these characters. The acting, as I say, is so stunning. The script is just one of the finest, personally for me, of all time. And I think just the use of music is beautiful. Really, really is. Adds the emotion as well to the film in many regards, and of course, yes, that bridge scene, I think really the final bridge scene, you know, could be one of the purest moments in the film. You know, this is a beautiful film, and all these different brief encounters, they're so meaningful, maybe because it's so fleeting and so kind of it's over just like that, and you kind of cherish these moments all the more, you could say. And you know, it's a film that, despite the short runtime, you know, these are some of the best characters for me in film. I think the development, you know, just this script, I think the editing as well is just so perfect, in the flow of it, and the way you get enough, you know, yeah, character development through the dialogue, and also the narration, also just seeing these these actors play out these, you know, these characters just so perfectly. And yes, you know, this is a film that also kind of deals with, you know, expectations and, of course, conforming, you know, as well as kind of breaking out of this conformity, you know, kind of going against the rules, perhaps. But it's kind of deals with both sides. And in the end, as we know, unfortunately, the characters do not end up together. But that's something that's just, it's a very complex film in that sense, but it is kind of, I think, very tragic, you know, in the way it ends. As I say, it could have been even higher on my list if it kind of ended with them ending up together. You know, kind of, I do love my kind of happy endings, but This is a film that, despite that, I think it is one of my absolute favourite films. When I saw this, instantly, you know, this became one of my favourites. I think standout characters, some of my very favourite characters, just this charming Alec, of course, and kind of the way in which this is just so comforting to see these characters be together, you know, looking after one another and offering, kind of agreeing on many, many, you know, aspects of life. And of course, all the more tragic because these characters do seem kind of fitting to be together, but of course they don't end up together. And, you know, despite being very, very sad, I think the ending kind of moment, of course, when the train leaves and Alec, you know, goes off, it is one of the greatest moments in cinema for me. I think this is one of the most wonderful films ever made, in my opinion. It's an absolute flawless masterpiece in my eyes, and just absolutely one of the very, very best films, and in my top 75 of all time. So overall, this film, of course, gets an extremely, extremely high rating of 100% plus, tier one. Wow, what a film this is. And of course, this film is actually one of my very, very highest, you know, tier one films. Very, very close to that tier S mark, actually. I'll let you in on that. Of course, simply to decide that, you know, what would be, where it would be, you know, just kind of this edge of the line or that end, is simply because, you know, I can't keep, you know, kind of letting films in that are just about there, but not quite. There has to be some kind of separation for what is effectively my bonus tier, the tier S. Really, you know, tier one, if it's, you know, my highest, one of my highest tier ones, it is kind of pretty much my highest rating. But then the other films just get a bit more kind of this bonus quality. They just go a little bit further. And I have to say, just for my enjoyment of the film, just for my, you know, my connection to the film, it is so, so close. You know, this really, it could be, you know, maybe on a few more watches, you know, tier S actually, but for now, you know, and that doesn't necessarily mean, you know, because I've seen it just two times, but for now, I think it really gets one of my highest recommendations ever, and, you know, just in cinema, but it simply isn't quite there in the tier S mark, and there is just a little bit of a jump from, you know, this film to a couple of others in the tier S, and there has to be some kind of separation for the likes of, you know, kind of course, A Clockwork Orange or City Lights or you know, Barry Lyndon, you know, films like this with some of these films. But yes, you know, this film, you know, the tier one films, of course, are films that, you know, are life-changing to me, and, you know, are ones that kind of represent, you know, what I love really most about cinema. This is a pure film, a wonderful, beautiful romance, of course, with a kind of twist, you know, in the outcome. Very, very sad ending, you know, really brings me to tears. And of course, she does end up putting it back. Of course, it's very complex. People have different views on this film, but I think it is very sad to me. And I am sure I do know, you know, many, many others, of course. Yes, just so invested, as I've said, these characters individually, you know, such strong characters, some of the most memorable interactions between the characters, and just a kind of a real overall purity and a sense of kind of beauty that I've rarely seen in a film. And yes, just what a unique experience, and one that is just truly, truly powerful. You know, really is an extremely emotional film for me, and you know, I couldn't, it's another one of them films I couldn't even try to review this on the night of watching it, because it just, it's too emotional in the way it kind of ends and stuff. And yes, a real beautiful film. You know, these fleeting moments, as I've said, you know, I just cherish them. You know, the moments, of course, in the cinema, you know, just even, you know, the meeting, and just the way the film's structured, in the way it does tell all this, and then it links back to that beginning scene just before the ending to kind of deliver that gut punch. It is just so effective because of its simplicity, and I think just a beautiful film. It really, really is. The performances, wonderful. Cyril Raymond as well, playing Fred, the husband, so, so good, and a kind of feeling different sympathy as well there, but it's this romance between these two characters, the longing to be together, and the way in which it's presented, the execution of this, that's of course what cinema is about at the end. Once you've watched the film, how it's been executed, and how you therefore connect to a particular film. Every film is different, of course, and this may not be a film that everyone loves, but it is a film that I love, and I do have, you know, really fond memories of first watching this film a couple of years ago, just being really transported and just moved to the core. And as I say, a pure, you know, spiritual, romantic film with, of course, a very dark outcome. And of course, if it had been a bit different in that sense, maybe I could have given it the tier S. But just on this occasion, it's very, very close to that tier S mark, and something that is, you know, one of my highest tier one recommendations. An absolute masterpiece of cinema, and just a beautiful, wonderful experience. So yes, tell me your thoughts in the comments. It'd be great to talk about this film, and again, David Lean, always great to talk about this director, this filmmaker, and this is one of his real gifts, I think, to us viewers, to anyone that loves cinema. So yes, as always, thanks for watching my review.